G'day folks, Rod from My Water Filter here today. And what we're gonna do is just have a look at a couple of reverse osmosis water filters, okay? And the object here is to just show you how fast the water flows out of a reverse osmosis water filter. Sometimes when people go for the portable model, they'll give us a call and suggest that they were expecting a better water flow. So I just want you to be aware of how fast it comes out, how long it'll take you to create water. Don't get me wrong, the membranes in these reverse osmosis systems, they really wring the water out and they take the contamination out of the water well, but they do create water slowly and you just need to be aware of that, all right? So this is a reverse osmosis system. It's connected up to the bench top here. It's one of our RO4000 line. And I'm just gonna turn it on slowly now so you can just have a look at how fast the water will come out of this system, all right? So we'll just turn it on gently. The black hose is the waste and the blue hose is the pure water. Generally, when you turn it on, the black hose will start to run first until there's pressure on the membrane. And once there's pressure on the membrane, the blue hose will start to create the pure water. So black hose, never drink that water. It's concentrated chemicals and contaminants from your water supply. And this blue hose is just beautiful, clean, pure water, okay? Now that's how fast the water's gonna flow. We've pulled this RO4000 to pieces till there was nothing left, and we've changed it and upgraded it as the best we can. To achieve the highest flow rates from these machines, we've put larger membranes in them, and don't get me wrong, this machine will make hundreds of liters in a day if you just leave it running. But if you're just gonna intend on turning it on and off, this is the water flow that you're going to achieve. Most commonly, or a lot of the time, people will have some containers to fill up with it, and they'll just put the blue hose in there, the black hose down the waste or in the bucket for the garden, and they'll just fill up your own container so you've got your storage, okay? Similar thing applies to a permanent system. So this system here obviously goes under the sink. And once again, this system here, the Extreme 7, that is going to have the same water flow that you're looking at here now, okay? And hence we have the tank so that you can have water on demand. So the system's set up under the sink, the system's constantly making water, and the tank fills up with water, and then the water is delivered from the tank to the faucet up on top of the sink. And it does that by the bag. There's an air bag in this tank, and as the water's forced into the tank, it compresses the bag, the tank fills, and the machine will stop flowing. As soon as you come along and hit the faucet on the sink, it's the bag in the tank that pushes the water along the line and up out of the tank. Up out of the spout. So the tank's gonna fill at this rate you're looking here now, a couple of hundred mils a minute. But when you wanna get water out of your tap, because of the tank and the bag with a permanent system, you'll have a full flow out of your kitchen sink tap. It's a 12 litre tank, and you will always have a good full flow out of your tap. As soon as you run some water down in the tank, the system starts making water again, and it'll fill the tank up again, okay? So that's about it. Just get your eye on there. That's the flow rate you'll have. It does make amazing water, no doubt about it. It's just that it will make it slowly because of the process. Thanks very much.